Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. We're doing this live from FWA. Well, maybe not live, but I'm shooting this at FWA. So there, that's what we're doing. I'm here Thursday, shooting this for you, all for you. Well, it's been a very long time since I've been able to make one of these, and hopefully I still know what I'm doing, but there's been something on my mind for quite some time now, and I felt like now's a great time to make a new video for all of you out there that have been so very, very patient with me. In recent years, I've come to the conclusion that the main cause of most of my problems more oftentimes happens to be, well, myself. And I feel that this is not so much removed from the general populace, and it's myself, and I'm not exactly special in this regard. I feel that most of the time, I have the habit of hurting my own cause, as it were. So, how am I doing this? How am I undermining my own attempts at making the world a better place? And how might some of you out there be doing the very same thing as me? Well, I'm going to tell you, or at least I'm going to try to tell you. Hi, I'm Spin, and today I want to talk to you about being too sensitive. It's easy to get wrapped up in your own ideologies, and even easier to allow the same ideologies to become so personal that anyone questioning them, or even asking why you believe the things that you believe, becomes indistinguishable from, say, personal attacks. This has been a particularly difficult thing for me to address about myself, because it indicates that I have a great deal of bias when it comes to certain ideologies. I do not believe that I am somehow special in this case. In fact, I believe this to be very common for people to become so wrapped up in their own thoughts, it becomes so much a part of who they are that they are no longer able to look at their own ideologies from a critical standpoint. It becomes more of a problem of separating what is rational and logical from opinions. This can be an exceptionally painful process, as I myself have found out, because when presented with irrefutable proof that what I was believing was not logical, or even scientifically accurate for that matter, it actually caused me mental distress. This mental distress was caused by something called cognitive dissonance, which I'm fairly certain I did a video on at some point, so link for that will be in the description or something. But the point is that I almost didn't change my mind on something because I was too in love with how believing a certain way made me feel, and anyone trying to pull me out of that was met with open hostility. In short, I was way too sensitive about my own beliefs, and especially the ones I couldn't back up with logic, reason, or fact, but somehow I knew that these were the right ones? Somehow? They were the right ones to me, because believing them made me feel good, either about myself or about other people, or allowed me, in some cases, to look down on other people, which made me feel good, unfortunately. And that last one can be highly addictive, which can prevent you from ever seeing the other side of the argument. So, how did all of this hurt my own cause? Well, unfortunately, sometimes, no matter how good your intentions or beliefs may be, they can run contrary to your goals. But that seems a little vague, so let me give you an example. Say I'm trying to convince somebody of a certain action that they are taking is immoral or otherwise quasi-illegal, and that they definitely should stop doing what they're doing. And also say that I get so indignant about this person's behavior, and I become so enamored with my own smug sense of self-righteousness that I completely alienate this individual from listening to another word I have to say. Now, it feels great to cast aspersions on other people and look down upon them because you feel like you have the moral or ethical high ground, regardless of whether or not you do or do not. But in that case, what is your real goal? Is your goal for that person to change their behavior and otherwise become a better version of themselves and contribute to society in an overall positive way in the future? Is that what you want? Or do you want to kick someone while they're down and continue kicking them because, hey, it's not you, and that feels pretty good? For a lot of people, it's easy to fall into that bandwagon mentality and just continue to kick the person while they're down, and effectively, that strategy is one that you would take if what you were looking for is not a change in society or a change in the person, but revenge on society or that person. And in this way, you have ensured that this person is no longer going to listen to you and no longer going to take your advice, but may in fact go the opposite direction. This is what we call radicalization, and it happens all the time when one group decides that they are morally or ethically superior to another and proceeds to dogpile on another group or individual. And that individual just has enough and decides, well, if you think that I'm the villain, well, I guess I'll be that villain for you. This is completely and totally counterproductive to any type of growth that any of us may want to see in an individual or group that we are supposedly trying to help. So what do we do about this? How do we stop ourselves from falling into the trap of self-aggrandizement? Well, first thing is that we are going to absolutely have to recognize when we are being too sensitive about a belief or an ideology that we hold far too dear to ourselves. You can usually recognize this by a belief or something that doesn't seem to be truly logical, and you may get overly upset by someone questioning that belief. A good rule of thumb is if you can't question the ideology or belief, then that might not be as couched in logic and reason as you may want to think it is. In that case, you may want to take a step back from the ideology and examine it critically and be open to people's thoughts and opinions, and most importantly, their questions. Now, this, of course, gets us close to a different thought of, well, if their thoughts and opinions and questions are offensive, then what? Well, unfortunately, to have an open and honest conversation about anything, you're more than likely going to get offended at something that someone has to say. And so long as you can keep in mind the differences between who you are and some ideology that you hold, and know that an attack on the ideology is not necessarily an attack on you, then that will most definitely solve that. Provided that people are capable of doing this, which more often than not, they're not. This, of course, is not easy and is something that you have to constantly practice. But over time, you will get better at separating the self from a held belief or ideology. And only when that happens will you be able to have those conversations that can lead to an even greater truth or better understanding between people. Lastly, I want to encourage all of you out there to work on the understanding that the whole purpose of a conversation or a debate, as it were, is for you to get your point across to the other person so that they can see it from your side. It is not necessarily for you to convince them that your way is best. In fact, the only person capable of changing your mind is you. I could spend all day telling you something, and if you choose to simply not believe me, well, that's it, game over. That's all I can do. I believe this is so critical that we learn how to be less sensitive about our opinions, thoughts, or ideologies, so that we do not undermine our own cause by taking things personally and burning bridges with other people. All right, guys, well, thanks so much for watching the video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for more content like this. We do try to do weekly live streams whenever we have time. We're trying to nail that down now, so hopefully that'll be much more smooth in the future. I definitely hope that all of you got something out of this video. And if it feels like I was talking about you, well, maybe you see something in this video that is a reflection of yourself. And the real question is, do you want to work on that? And as always, guys, I have some words to leave you with. It is a mark of a well-educated mind to be able to entertain a thought without accepting it. Bye.